Hello everyone, in this lecture we will solve one numerical on torque analysis of epicyclic gear trains. So here is my problem statement. A gear wheel A having 44 teeth is rigidly mounted on the driving shaft and it gears with compound wheel CD. Wheel C has 22 teeth and wheel D has 26 teeth. C gears with A and D gears with internal wheel B. The compound wheel revolves freely on a pin which projects from an arm which is rigidly mounted on the driven shaft. The internal wheel B is fixed and module of all the gears is the same. The driving, driven and internal wheel are coaxial. Driving shaft rotates at 300 rpm and transmits 2.5 kilowatts of power. If I have to sketch the arrangement, find the speed of driven shaft, find the torque transmitted by the driven shaft, as well as determine the fixing torque required on the fixed element. So first of all, let us draw the gear arrangement for this type of gear train. So we'll draw the vertical axis, horizontal axis of gear train. This is the main axis of epicyclic gear train. So gear A mounted on the driving shaft. Gear A is in mesh with gear C and C is compounded with gear D. You can read here. Gear A is mounted on the driving shaft. Okay, and C gears with A. So C gears with A. And C is compounded with D. So C is compounded with D. They are on the same shaft. And now D gears with internal wheel B. Okay. So let us draw the internal wheel B. So this is my internal gear B, which is in mesh with wheel D. Okay. Now next, the compound wheel, that is this CD, revolves freely on a pin which projects from an arm rigidly mounted on the driven shaft. Okay. And the driving, driven and internal wheel are coaxial. So already I have shown gear B and gear A coaxial. Now driven gear is also coaxial with both of these gears, and driven shaft is coaxial with these both gears, and it carries an arm with a pin, and in that pin compound wheel CD is carried on by the arm. So this is my arm which is having a pin here on which compound wheel CD revolves. And this arm is connected to the driven shaft, which is coaxial with gears A and B. So let us extract the given data. Number of teeth on gear A are 44. Number of teeth on gear C 22. And number of teeth on gear D are 26. Speed of gear A is given as 300 rpm. Ring gear B is fixed. So speed of gear B, that is NB, is equals to 0. Input gear transmits the power of 2.5 kilowatt. We have to find out the speed of arm E. Then we'll find out the braking torque acting on the fixed gear B and the torque on gear E. Okay, so let us do it. So first of all, we'll find out the unknown number of teeth on gear B. Okay, number of teeth on gear A, gear C and D are known. They are 44, 26 and 22. We'll find out the number of teeth on gear B from the geometry of the arrangement of gears. Now you can easily see that radius of gear B is equals to radius of gear A plus radius of gear C plus radius of gear D. So that is what I have written here. RB, radius of gear B is equals to RA plus RC plus RD, radius of gear A plus C plus D. Now in the problem statement, it is mentioned that pitch of all the gears is same. So when this is the condition, we can consider that pitch circle radius are proportional to the number of teeth. So let us modify this equation. So now we have TB is equals to TA plus TC plus TD because the pitch of all the gears is same. So we'll substitute the values of TA, TC and TD, which are 44, 22 and 26. So that gives number of teeth on gear B as 92. So now next step is to draw the table. We'll count the number of members, total number of members in gear train. How many are they? 1, 2, 3, 4 and arm 6. So we need 6 columns, but gears C and D are compounded, so they will have the same speed. So we'll reduce one column, so draw the 5 columns. First column is always for steps, second is reserved for arm, which is E for this case. Next column is for the gear, which we are going to rotate in step number 2. So we are going to rotate gear A in step number 2. So column next to arm is gear A. Now A is in mesh with C. Okay, A drives C. So obviously the next column will be for gear C. C and D will have same speeds. So same column for gear C and D. Now D is in mesh with B, so last column is for gear B. Now step number 1. Let us fix all the members to the arm and rotate the arm by Y number of revolutions. Under this condition, all the members will rotate with the speed of the arm, that is Y revolutions. Okay. So speeds of all the members is Y because all the members are fixed to the arm and arm is rotating with Y rotations. Now in step 2, we'll free the constraints in step 1 and now we'll fix the arm. So arm fixed. Arm fixed and we'll rotate gear A by X number of revolutions. Okay, we'll rotate gear A by X number of revolutions. Now arm is fixed, so speed of arm E is 0. We are rotating gear A by X number of revolutions, so speed of gear A is X. Under this condition, we will find out the speeds of gears C, D and B. So let us do that. A drives C. So for this pair in mesh, we have the equation for velocity ratio. Speed of driving gear divided by speed of driven gear, and that is equals to number of teeth on driven gear divided by number of teeth on driving gear. So NA upon NC is equals to TC upon TA. We are interested in finding speed of gear C. So let us take NC to the left hand side and all other terms to the right. So we have NC is equals to NA into TA divided by TC. But we know NA, right? We know NA. NA is X. So let us substitute X for NA. Okay? So we have done that. For NA, I have written X. Now, we have to use negative sign here because A drives C in opposite direction through external meshing. And the axis of gear C is parallel to the axis of gear train. So we will go with the sign convention. So for opposite direction of rotation, we will use negative sign for velocity ratio. So this is the speed of gear C as well as gear D. So let us tabulate the speed. Now next, we'll find out speed of gear B. Now B is driven by wheel D. So for that, we have the equation for velocity ratio as speed of driving gear ND divided by speed of driven gear NB. This is equals to number of teeth on driven gear TB divided by number of teeth on driving gear TD. We are interested in speed of gear B. So let us take NB to the left hand side and all other terms to the right side of the equation. So this is speed NB. Now we know ND, right? ND is minus X into TA upon TC. So let us substitute the value of ND in this equation. Now we are finding speed of gear B, and axis of gear B is also parallel to the axis of gear train. So we have to use the sign convention. Now according to the sign convention, D drives B in same direction because of internal meshing. So no negative sign, we will go with positive sign. So the speed of B is as it is, we will tabulate in the table. Now let us find out the total motion of all the members by adding the speeds in step 1 and step 2. So we have speed of arm E, and E is equals to Y. Speed of gear A is X plus Y. Speed of gear C and D is Y minus X into TA upon TC. And speed of gear B is Y minus X into TA upon TC into TD upon TB. So we have four equations with us. Speeds of these members, speed of arm E, gear A, gear B and compound wheel CD. We are interested in finding speed of arm E, which is equals to Y. So we need to find out the value of Y from the given input conditions, which are NB is equals to 0 and NA equals to 300. So I will take the first equation, NA is equals to X plus Y, and this is equals to 300, right? So I have equation number 1 as X plus Y is equals to 300. Now I will take the equation of NB, which is Y minus X into TA upon TC into TD upon TB, and this is equals to 0. So let us put the values of all the terms. NB is 0 because B is fixed. TA is 44. TD is 26. TC is 22. And TB, which we have just determined, is 92. Okay. So after solving this, we get Y is equals to X into 0.56. Now let us solve equation number 1 and 2 and get the values of X and Y. So I put Y is equals to X into 0.56 in equation number 1. This is for Y. So 300 is equals to X into 1.56. That gives me X as 192.3. Now I can use any one of these equations, equation 1 or 2, to get the value of Y. So Y is 107.68. That is my NE, which is in question. So NE is equals to Y, and that is equals to 107.68 RPM. So next, we have to determine the torque acting on gear E. Okay, for that, we will assume that the gear train operates under 100% efficiency. There are zero frictional losses. So in this, or under this condition, the net kinetic energy dissipated by the gear train will be zero. That is, summation of torque into speed will be zero. So TA into NA is the kinetic energy on gear A, which is the input gear. TB into NB, kinetic energy on gear B, and TE into NE, kinetic energy for arm E. Now remember that we are not considering gears C and D because they are not transmitting external torques. A is connected to the external member. Arm E is connected to the external member, that is output shaft. Gear B is fixed, so it is also connected to the external member. So we are considering only these three members. Okay, so this is my equation for sigma Tn is equals to 0, but we know that gear B is fixed. So Nb, that is speed of gear B, is 0. Let us modify the equation. We have Ta into Na plus Te into Ne is equals to 0. We want Te, torque on gear E. So let us take Te to the left hand side and all other terms to the right side. So this is my equation to find out torque on gear E. Now to solve this equation, we have Ne with us, which is determined just now, that is equals to 107.68. Na is given as 300 rpm, right? So in order to solve this equation, we must first of all determine the value of torque acting on gear A. That can be done easily because the power transmitted by gear A is given. So here we go, power by A is equals to 2 pi into speed of gear A into torque on gear A divided by 60. So we have Ta is equals to 60 into Pa divided by 2 pi into Na. So we'll substitute the values of Pa and Na. Na is 300, Pa is 2.5 into 10 raised to 3. So we get torque transmitted by gear A as 79.57 Newton meters. Now we will substitute this value in this equation to get the value of Te. So Te is now minus 221.6 Newton meters. This is the torque transmitted by arm E. Now for holding torque, we will assume that all the gears are rotating with uniform speed. There is no acceleration in the system. So under this condition, we can consider that the gear train is in equilibrium under the action of external torques acting on it. So Ta plus Tb plus Te, all of these are the external torques. So summation of these three terms will be equals to 0. I am interested in braking torque, which is acting on the fixed member. And in this case, we have fixed the internal gear B. So the resisting torque offered by gear B, which is called as holding torque or fixing torque, that will be equals to minus into whole bracket Ta plus Te. We have the values of Ta and Te. Ta is 79.57 and Te is minus 221.6. So after solving this, we get 142 Newton meters. It's plus, okay? Plus 142 Newton meter is the fixing torque acting on gear B. Thank you. In next lecture, we'll solve one more numerical on torque analysis of epicyclic gear train.